Yeah, that leg is better. What do you folks say your names were?
I'm Niklas Gustafsson. And this is my brother, Jakob.
Where are you all from?
Norway.
Well, I admire you making the journey west. It's a hard run. I know I've done it. Come up west on a wagon train from Arkansas. I was just a boy. Not much more than your age. Trip is going just fine until we all came to a little knot in the road in Utah. Place called Mountain Meadows. See, my mammy and pappy, most everybody else, were all killed. By Indians, looked like. Except when these Indians washed their faces, their skin was white. Turns out they all came from the Great Salt Lake. Men of religion, they said. Well, some of these religious men applied themselves to my sister before they killed her. Got the pretend war paint all over her real skin. My baby brother Liam wouldn't stop fussing while they was raping and killing my family, so they grabbed him by the feet and smashed his head on a wagon wheel. Hook that one there. They killed over 100 people that day, including my mammy, pappy, and Liam, older sister Lori, my aunt and uncle, and their little girl, cousin Phoebe. One of them, Mr. Isaac Haight, was all the time preaching to the men doing the killing about how all things are purified with blood, how without the shedding of blood, there is no remission. He said how he's given us all eternal salvation, spilling our Gentile blood in the dirt. I heard him say how killing Gentiles was a means of grace, and a virtuous deed. And I thought to myself, After he saved my family, Mr. Isaac Haight became my new pappy and one of his wives, my new mammy. My family, like all the families we was traveling with, had a considerable amount of gold and personal property, all of which my new family took right good care of. Mr. Haight gained 10 pounds just so he could fit in my old pappy's clothes. I remember seeing one of his 14 wives wearing one of my mammy's skirts in church. But the image I have of my family is looking back at them as Mr. Haight took us away. Their bodies left to fester, corrupt in the hot sun. I learned to love Mr. Haight. He taught me with the stick and the bullwhip and the knife how to love. Same as I love Roy Good now. For he's my son. I chose him. And that is a more powerful bond, more powerful love than being born into it. I aim to show him that love when we meet up again. We know he came through this way. Skinny little fella. Kind you might mistakenly underestimate.
We've not seen anyone.
Of course, he may be dead. But then he's been dead before, so. Well, then. I think that tonight we're just gonna bed down over there. In the morning we'll move on, leave you folks be. But before we do, I need you two gentlemen to decide which of your lovely wives is gonna visit me in my blankets.
What done like her do?
Nei, Nicola.
Of
course, if you both want to come along, you're more than welcome.